Hi, today I'm going to show you how to drive a 12-volt LED strip from an Arduino. And to accomplish this, we're using a N Channel Mosfet. Now, obviously, the Arduino cannot power the LED strip directly. First of all, the Arduino can only put out a maximum of 5 volts. Secondly, you can only draw a small amount of power from each pin, so obviously it wouldn't be enough to light up this whole LED strip. Now I'm going to keep this video quite basic because there's already quite a lot of videos and information out there about MOSFETs and the Arduino. So I'm really just going to keep it basic and let you set it up and get going in, you know, a couple of minutes. And then if you want to know more about it, you can always do more research. Now an N-channel MOSFET has 3 pins: the gate, the drain, and the source. So it's gate, drain, source. Now source is where our power is going to come in, for instance from our battery. The drain is where it's going to go out, and the gate is how we're going to control those pins there and basically connect them together. So what do you need to do this? Well, you need your Arduino, obviously, which I'm just running from a USB power pack. You need your N-channel MOSFET. Pretty much anyone would do. Just check to make sure that it can handle the amount of amps you want to push through it, and ideally go for the L series, which is logic, which means that the gate pin can be driven from a low voltage, for instance the 5 volt of an Arduino. You need your 12 volt LED strip, you need your 12 volt power source, in my case I'm using a 12 volt battery, and then you just need some wires to connect everything together. Now you can do this on a breadboard, but to keep things simple I'm not going to. So the first thing you want to do is take your positive from the battery, your 12 volt source, and connect that to the positive of your LED strip. The next thing you want to do is take your negative from your 12 volt power source and connect that to the gate drain source. So this pin here, which is your source. Next, you want to connect your drain, which is the middle pin. So that's this one here, but this tab here is also considered the middle pin. So I'm going to connect it there. And you'll take that over to your LED strip. Okay, now you need to connect the ground of your Arduino to the ground of the battery. So I'm just going to use this little jumper cable to do that. You can see that the lights are flickering a little bit. That's because the gate is actually picking up a little bit of charge which is left inside, a static charge. Once we connect it, we'll be able to control that. So ground from the Arduino to ground of the battery. There you go. And then I've already flashed the fade sketch onto here. So you can see pin 13 is fading on and off. I'm not sure how easily you'll be able to see that. So we'll connect the jumper cable to pin 13. And we'll connect that to the gate pin of the MOSFET, which is the one on the very left. And now you can see that it's making the 12 volt LED strip fade, the same as pin 13 on here. And it's really that simple. So what's actually happening here? Well, the negative from the battery comes through to the source pin right here. Then it drains out through the drain pin to the LED strip. And basically we're connecting these two pins, or opening them, closing them, by telling the gate, hey, open, close. And we're creating the fade effect using standard PWM. So I'll bring the camera closer and give you a good look at what's actually going on here. So let's take a closer look at what's going on here. You have the positive of the battery going through to the positive of the LED strip. Then you have the negative of the battery coming through to the source pin of the N-channel MOSFET. And then it's going out of the drain pin, which is the middle pin here, and that's going through to the LED strip. So basically, the negative is going through here, going to the N-channel MOSFET, and then going out the N-channel MOSFET. And we're controlling when these two are connected or when it's opened or closed by using this pin here, which is the gate pin. And that's connected to the Arduino via pin 13 here. And because we have the fade sketch on pin 13, when it fades pin 13, it's sending that signal through to the MOSFET, which is then opening and closing this connection very fast. And that's creating the PWM fade right here. So you can consider it kind of like plumbing. When you tell this pin to open it, it's going to let everything flow between these two pins. And when you tell it to close, it stops it. And because it's opening and closing it so fast, it's varying the amount of power that's going through to the strip, and it's creating this nice PWM faded effect. So I hope this video has helped you understand how to use an N channel MOSFET. I've watched a lot of different videos and I really found it quite confusing. It had so many wires going everywhere that I couldn't easily understand it. And I am oversimplifying things in this video, but it's enough to actually get you up and running, and then later on you can find out, you know, ways that you can do things better. Now the important thing to remember is to join the ground from your 12 volt power source to the ground of your Arduino. If you don't do that, you won't be able to drive the MOSFET. Now there is a difference between P-channel MOSFETs and N-channel MOSFETs, and I'm not going to go into the difference, but basically a P-channel MOSFET is going to make your life hell, and the N-channel MOSFET is going to make it super easy. So unless you have a specific reason why you need to use the P-channel MOSFET, don't bother. So just remember, gate, drain, source. Whenever you put a positive voltage on the gate, it's going to make the drain and the source connect and the power will flow through. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please remember to give a thumbs up and subscribe. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below.